Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy-to-understand whiteboard videos. And today I'll be sharing with you what is SAP IBP and provide you with a brief introduction to it. So, let's get started. Here, IBP stands for Integrated Business Planning and focuses on bringing inventory, sales, financial, and supply planning processes into a single, consistent, and seamless plan. And in turn, we can easily state that it is a cloud-based solution that helps businesses effectively manage their operational and strategic goals in an integrated environment. Further, some of the SAP IBP's key features include: number one, it promotes collaboration across verticals in an organization. Number two, if compared with any other existing SAP module, SAP IBP offers a quite exceptionally user-friendly interface. Number three, it offers real-time simulations for various business scenarios in order to meet the growing business demand, supply, and financial models of an organization. Exciting, right? Well, to make such execution possible, plans are approved by executives at all levels of management, which makes it easier to align supply and demand, execution, strategic, and tactical planning of a business. Further, SAP IBP plays an integral part in the broad SAP S/4HANA ecosystem. It has been specifically designed to help various businesses manage complex supply chains and streamline operation at various levels. Here, every module in this solution includes a standardized data model which helps provide real-time supply chain visibility. And as you know, having a real-time vision is a great help when it comes to making business decisions. And furthermore, this is only possible all thanks to the dedicated integrated planning environment of SAP IBP, which allows multiple users to run different simulations, perform different scenarios in the planning cycle, and makes it easy to handle any exception with the system alerts. Overall, we can say that SAP IBP management can help accelerate the planning process and decision making for any business, as it makes use of two interfaces to optimize the user experience, which includes a web interface for planning and Microsoft Excel for decision making. Further, SAP IBP is made up of four foundational components: sales and operations, demand, inventory, and response and supply. Here, the supply chain control tower acts as the central visual interface of all the IBP components, and each component is independent. Do note that, and you can use only what you need whenever you need it. Now, let's look into each of these components one by one. Number one, sales and operations. So, SAP IBP for sales and operations, or to state S&OP, is the heart of this module. It allows for seamless integration of sales and operations planning in a business, and typically it includes the steps of supply and demand review, balance, and integrations. Here, users can easily perform different analysis and integration, which allows them to envision and model different scenarios. It also allows stakeholders to align their long-term strategic plan with short-term operational planning to increase the supply, utilization, and timely delivery to customers. Number two, demand. SAP IBP for demand provides a precise demand plan which can be used to forecast accurately and allows for efficient execution. Its ability to calculate accurate forecast using advanced algorithms through demand sensing is extremely helpful, and as we all know, a fully integrated demand planning helps in lowering inventory cost, and higher service levels can be achieved. Next, number three, inventory. Now, SAP IBP for inventory assists in advanced inventory planning for highly complex supply chains. Here, planners can easily perform single-level, multi-level inventory optimizations as well as run analysis on the basis of different scenarios. This further helps in standardized inventory target setting at each level of the supply chain. Now, here, some advantages of using SAP IBP for inventory include improving delivery service and reducing working capital, increasing efficiency and productivity, utilizing advanced algorithms that effectively balance inventory investment and service levels at each supply chain link, and determining where and how much inventory should be made available in different sourcing environments. Next, number 4, response and supply. SAP IBP for response and supply helps to perform capacity planning and analysis on the basis of several constraints across the supply chain. It stimulates planning and evaluates them on different scenarios, considering procurement, inventory, warehousing, cost of production, and procurement, etc. It further takes into account the demand variability and considers how to best allocate constrained resources to ensure high level of quality service while still keeping the cost low. Further, it's worth noting that Supply Chain Control Tower alerts you to any disruptions in the supply chain. It majorly includes what-if analysis and analytical tools for rapid and informed decision-making to any problem in the supply chain. Here, the data is available beyond organizational boundaries, so everyone has a consistent view of the supply chain. And do remember that the tools in the control tower are highly visual, so charts and tables can be quickly passed along without possibly overwhelming the display of numbers. Lastly, as a conclusion, I'd like to say that SAP IBP module can fulfill future demand profitability with real-time supply chain management. It is powered by in-memory computing technology with SAP HANA, which empowers this cloud-based solution with the capabilities of sales and operation, demand, response and supply planning, and inventory optimization in support of your company's integrated business strategy. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.